There are three primary side mount regulator configurations, one of which is similar to the classic Hogarthian or long hose setup with a few minor variations. This configuration has been widely adopted as part of the standard Mexican-style side-mount rig made popular by Steve Bogertz. It offers flexibility and a wide range of options for managing emergencies. Additionally, it aligns with both single back mount and twin set systems, allowing for smoother transitions and integration when diving within mixed configuration teams. We strongly encourage divers to assemble their own equipment, as the process provides a comprehensive understanding of their gear, enabling them to grasp its functionality and intricacies. This hands-on experience not only deepens their familiarity with the equipment, but also enhances their ability to address minor issues as they arise. The essential components include two DIN-type first stages with swivel turret and fifth port, two second stages. Ideally, the brand should be consistent with that of the first stages. A 2.1 meter IP hose. A short IP hose tailored to your measurements. One 90 degree adapter. One low pressure inflator hose for the wing and another for the dry suit. Two SPGs and two 15 to 20 centimeters long high pressure hoses. A regulator necklace bungee. A small bolt snap. An O-ring and a zip tie for the long hose breakaway connection. To build your regulators, you will need a selection of tools. An Allen key is required to remove the blanking plugs from the first stage. While the size may vary by manufacturer, we are using a 5mm key. You will also need wrenches in various sizes, typically ranging from 14 to 18 millimeters to attach the hoses. Additionally, it is advisable to have lubricant on hand to treat the O-rings within the regulator assembly. We'll begin by setting up the short hose system. The first step is to remove the blanking plug from the fifth port of the first stage. This will allow for the attachment of the wing's inflator hose. Next, detach another plug from the swivel turret to connect the regulator hose. Lastly, take out a plug from one of the high-pressure ports to secure the SPG. You can choose any of the ports for your regulator as it's located on the swivel turret, so you can position it wherever you need to once it's connected. However, to position the SPG correctly, you need to attach it to the bottom port, which is the one facing down when you hold your first stage in the position it will be attached to your cylinder. Before connecting hoses, second stages, and SPGs, thoroughly inspect each O-ring for any signs of damage and replace them if needed. Although lubrication is typically advised for moving components, we advocate applying lubricant to all O-rings as an additional precaution. Carefully thread the shorter second stage hose into the designated port on the swivel turret. During this process, either allow the hose to roll naturally on your workbench or let it hang directly from the first stage. This will ensure smooth threading and prevent any damage to the grooves. Connect the 90-degree elbow to the end of the hose. Should you encounter resistance while threading, it is preferable to restart the process rather than force the connection. This precaution, as with any threading, helps prevent potential damage to the components. Proceed by attaching the second stage to the elbow. Refrain from applying excessive force when using a wrench. A gentle turn just beyond finger tight is sufficient. As this regulator will be worn around your neck, it is necessary to add a bungee necklace. Use a bungee approximately 60 centimeters long and 4 millimeters thick with simple knots at each end. Attach the bungee to the mouthpiece with a cable tie, as shown in the video. Ensure the cable tie is tightened enough to keep the mouthpiece securely attached to the regulator, yet loose enough to allow adjustment of the bungee by sliding it beneath the tie. For a clean finish, trim the end of the cable tie with a nail clipper, which effectively rounds the edge without leaving sharp points. Attach the SPG hose to the designated port on the first stage. Ensure you use an appropriately sized wrench, but avoid over-tightening the connection. Since the SPG features a swivel that allows rotation between the hose and the SPG head, lubrication is essential for smooth operation and longevity. Remove the small O-rings from both ends of the swivel, apply a thin layer of silicone grease, and then reinstall the O-rings. Be cautious not to apply excessive lubrication, as it could migrate into the bourdon tube mechanism and impair the accuracy of the SPG. Apply only a small amount of pure silicone grease, sufficient to give the O-ring a subtle sheen without forming a visible layer. Once the O-rings are lubricated and reinstalled, reinsert the swivel into the SPG. Securely attach the SPG to the hose by threading it and gently tightening with a wrench, following the same careful approach as with previous connections. This meticulous procedure will help ensure the integrity and optimal performance of your pressure gauge. Finally, connect the wing's inflator hose to the fifth port. The threading procedure is identical to the previous hoses. Depending on the design of the inflator hose's nut, you may be able to affix cable ties to it. This modification can facilitate handling the nut when attaching and detaching it from the inflator valve. Take two cable ties and connect them by securing them together from both ends. Tighten them to form a smaller loop, ensuring it remains sufficiently large for the nut to pass through. Position the loop over the small wedge on the nut and fasten it securely. Trim the excess ends of the ties with a nail clipper to achieve a smooth, clean finish. Proceed to the long hose regulator and begin by removing the required blanking plugs. The fifth port plug should be removed only when connecting a dry suit inflator hose, otherwise it should remain in place. If you're unsure which side of the first stage to attach the SPG, position the first stage as it would be mounted to the cylinder relative to your body. For example, as the long hose regulator is connected to the right side cylinder, the first stage would be on your right side with the DIN connection facing away from your body. In this orientation, the bottom high pressure port is the one designated for connecting your SPG. Next, connect the long hose to the low pressure port on the swivel turret of the first stage. Due to the hose's length, attaching it may be somewhat challenging. To facilitate this, it may be advantageous to rotate the first stage while keeping the hose in position. Gently tighten the connection with a wrench, following the same procedure used for the previous hoses. Attach the second stage to the end of the hose as demonstrated in the video. Adhere to the same procedure as previously outlined. To ensure the long hose is both clipped off when not in use and readily available for gas sharing, a breakaway mechanism is essential. While alternatives such as magnetic clips, hose retainers, and bungees are available, we recommend using an O-ring and cable tie configuration due to its ease of repair in the field. To implement this, you will need an O-ring commonly used for IP hoses and a high-quality zip tie. Be sure not to use a thicker O-ring, as it will be difficult to break in an emergency. Start by looping the O-ring around the closed end of the bolt snap, then affix the zip tie in a way that only holds the open ends of the O-ring together, without going under the closed end of the bolt snap. The placement should be at the base of the second stage. Most IP hoses have a machined flat section that is ideal for this placement. If not, position it near where the second stage connects to the IP hose. To see the breakaway bolt snap in action, check out our video on sidemount regulator skills by clicking the card in the upper right corner. Attaching the SPG necessitates the same procedure used for the short hose regulator assembly. Begin by affixing the hose to the first stage, followed by lubricating the swivel O-rings, and then securing the SPG onto the hose. Proper lubrication is particularly critical in side mount configurations due to the frequent repositioning of the SPGs for gas pressure verification. Lastly, attach the dry suit inflator hose to the fifth port. Hose length can vary depending on individual measurements and the positioning of the dry suit inflator valve. Choose a length that allows the hose to comfortably reach the necessary valve without being excessively long, which could create a loop or pose an entanglement hazard. Both regulators are now set and ready for testing. Thanks for watching and hope you learned something. Consider subscribing to FlowState Divers to become part of the community of conscious divers and to get notified on our upcoming content.